Oh no, it's the Custom Coaches Show! Custom
Culture! Hello, my fellow music minions, it's Greg Norrie here, and you're listening to the Custom Culture Show, fueled by Pistonhead Custom Lager.
We built it, you tilt it!
The show that always smells whatever you're cooking, and always picking up whatever you're throwing down. On today's show, we chat with the band Bellwoods about their innovative Cooking with Bellwoods webisodes, and also about writing happy songs about depression. Yikes. We also catch up with owner and operator Jerry Felice of the Village Cigar Company and Barbershop, who tells us about wanting to be buried in a cigar box when he dies. And we end things off with an interview that I'm way too excited to even tell you about now, so you'll have to listen to the end of the show to hear who it's with. All coming up on the Custom Culture Show. The band Bellwoods started as a collaboration between Morgan Cameron Ross of the now-defunct band Birds of Wales and Alan Snoddy of the Montreal-based band Stars. What makes Bellwoods a unique and worthy entity is that it's also a collective made up of whatever friends of theirs want to contribute to it. Friends such as Mary Lambert, who performed on and helped pen Macklemore and Ryan Lewis's hit song, Same Love, or Sum 41's Cone McCaslin, or Josh Traeger of the Sam Roberts Band, to name just a few. Here's my interview with Morgan and Alan at my recording studio in Toronto. I'm sitting here with Morgan Cameron Ross and Alan Snoddy of the band Bellwoods. So the band is made up of a number of different friends. There's no real consistent band with consistent members. It's more of a co-op where if you want this type of vibe, you'll bring in this type of drummer.
Exactly.
As a friend of yours.
Yeah.
Is there a criteria that they have to be a friend?
Well, a few of them is kind of questionable, but you know. As long as they're good players.
You tell them that they're good friends at the time.
Yeah, totally.
Until the track's done.
Yeah, totally.
And then you say, see you later, losers.
No. Bellwoods is a duo primarily. It's Alan and I. But we bring in our friends for all the different tracks.
Tell me, are there any favorite bars you guys have been hanging out at?
My guilty pleasure is a place called Toby's on College Street.
Okay, why do you like it?
They have amazing karaoke. So I end up there Sunday and Monday.
If the place is packed and your friends are egging you on to go up on stage, what's the song you're gonna pick?
Oh, man.
Living on a Prayer is a good one.
Living on a Prayer. That's a hard note to hit. Can you hit it?
And if you can't hit, I don't hit it. I just do the
he just does
the mic. Yeah.
I have a question for you guys, and this is a question that comes up quite often these days. The internet has allowed burning of music, and you can no longer make money off of the sell of it. On the flip side, though, you can market the hell out of your music for nothing. So you no longer need to rely on being signed to a label anymore. Of course, it puts the onus on the band to go and market themselves, and sometimes bands feel uncomfortable. Can you give advice as to how you have discovered to best navigate the social networks to be effective?
I think the best thing a band can do is create content that's flattering to them and interesting to people. So Alan here is a really good chef. Why don't we do something a bit weird? So we've done a video series, Cooking with Bellwoods. I saw Alan being a really good chef and cook, so we created this cooking series.
I think it's brilliant. Yeah. And I think this is the type of thing I tell bands all the time. To come up with something clever and creative that will attract people's attention. And it doesn't always have to be based on the music.
Exactly. So for our example is we have this video series of practical things that are a little bit tongue-in-cheek, but in the intro and the outro, we're using our song. So we're syncing we're getting a sync with our own little webisodes.
I'm sure that listeners right now are probably dying to hear some Bellwoods music.
How about we go with the song Get Back Up?
Is it about anything in particular?
Yeah, Blue Matter Project, it's a holistic approach to mental health, typically through yoga. So they asked me if I would write an uplifting, positive song about depression and mental health stuff. So Get Back Up came to be.
I've been down, I've been broken. I've been lost with no hope to be found. All my scars, I will show them as I'm lying here on the ground. I will get back up. Oh, oh, oh. I will stand near and shout it out loud. I will get back. No way I'm staying down. I will get back up. share this with each other. We find the strength to turn it around. To be found, I will get back.